My name is Mitch Rankin, and I share ideas that have been useful in my life. I love what Seneca said. It is not that we have a short time to live, but that we waste a lot of it. Life is long enough, and a sufficiently generous amount has been given to us for the highest achievement if it were all well invested. Life is long if you know how to use it.
The one thing I learned really on in my career and getting going was the difference between an asset and a liability. And just to recap, an asset is something that puts money into your pocket, and a liability is something that takes money out of your pocket. And that one idea has actually guided me through all my business decisions in life. When I've come to a crossroads where there's been a choice to make, I've always asked myself the question, is it an asset or is it a liability? And that has helped me to consistently over the years put assets in place that have created a passive income and given us the life that we want. And over the past years, we've had times when times have been tough, when our cash flow has diminished completely, when economic times have changed. And the one thing that we've done is just to keep focus on building the assets and not taking away from them. And we've had a cutback on expenses, we had a cutback on luxuries, had a cutback as our monthly cash flow shrunk, change vehicles, do different things, simplify our lives. But ultimately, at the end of the day, our assets have continued to grow. And looking forward to the next 10 years, we're trying to figure out, like, what does it look like? What does our life look like? What is going to create the memories, those relationships, and the experiences that are going to be worthwhile in the next 10 years? So we look back one day and said, wow, those 10 years were amazing. And the idea, something that Sue and I've wanted to do for many years, which we're planning to do now, is to buy a boat. It's probably going to be a trawler, maybe a 50, 55 foot trawler, and then go and start off by doing the Great Loop in America. And as our confidence and experience grows, start doing some ocean crossings, and then spend time traveling around the world in a beautiful vessel that'll be our home, that can really be an exploration trip and something that we can, you know, really enjoy together and enjoy with the kids, kiting and surfing and just beautiful places all over the globe. How are we going to do that? I've got absolutely no idea. I've got no clue. We've got to start researching, changing habits, doing things, learning new skills to get that done. But one thing I do know is I'm not going to buy a boat. What I'm going to do is I'm going to buy assets. I'm going to go and look for some property that can create an income for us, a revenue stream, that in that structure, we can buy a boat and we can expense it and we can actually put something together that keeps the idea consistent that we've been living with for all of these years, which is assets are things that put money into your pocket and liabilities are things that take money out of your pocket. And if we had to just go and buy a boat with its expenses and costs, it would just take money out of our pockets, and that's not what we're going to do. So will the result be the same? It'll be 100% the same. We'll have our boat, and we'll go traveling and exploring and have a wonderful life. But in the background, the same principle will always apply. We will be making the right decisions and spending our money on the right things, which are assets, and those assets will buy us the things, the luxuries that we want. So consistently over time, those assets are working for us, putting money into our pockets. And the thing that has brought us to this point in life, which has given us freedom, time freedom to do the things we want, to spend with the people we want, and really to live the life that we've designed, is putting assets in place. And there's a couple of things I could encourage you is, if you're thinking of changing some things in your life and creating time, the habits needed to develop assets are an important thing to start thinking about, because they are fundamentally different from the habits that most people have, which are work to buy things. And if you change that just very, very slightly from work to buy things to work to buy assets, and the assets buy you things, it'll fundamentally change your life.